So good afternoon all of you. Ready everyone? Is voice clear? Check it once. Join fast everyone. Yes, ready everyone. Join fast. Okay, so let's start. Today's topic is Quinn's interference tube. What is that? Quinn's interference tube. Listen carefully, very, very important. Quinn's interference tube. What is the topic name? Quinn's interference tube. So the scientist was George Herman Quincke, right? German physicist. And what he did, listen, very, very important, right? So everyone is, what you can say, able to hear. Can you see the video properly? Please tell me and give attendance also. Without attendance means I don't know how many are joining. Please give attendance. Okay. So everyone, board is audible and clear for everyone, voice and all these things. Okay, so let's start. So this topic is what? Quinn's interference tube. So yesterday we have learned interference, the interference topic, almost we are towards the end, and this is what? Quinn's interference tube. In this, what is the motto of this tube? Let's see first point. Okay, what is the first thing here? Okay. So what is this Quinn's tube? This is nothing but experimental setup to demonstrate interference of sound wave and also to find sound speed in air. What is the motto of this experiment? That is Quinn's interference tube. We can do in laboratory also, in our lab, this type of tubes we can make. Okay, so practically also I will tell you, ask me there, right? So first concentrate now, how it is and how to do this experiment. Any doubt? Everything is clear for everyone? Sound and video. Okay, so let's start. Now first of all, let us see the diagram of this tube. how it is. Listen carefully. Now, how it is? It is actually a U-shape, two tubes we can say. Two tubes are there. So how they are? At the beginning of interference, I told you actually this part, but not derivation. So today we are going to learn the derivation of this part also. That is this tube. Yes, you can see here. Wait, I think down you can't see. 1 minute. Let me take little up. So this is the diagram of the sphinx apparatus, we can say. Right? So you are having one U-tube like this with two openings. This is having two openings. Yes, you can see now. Very good. So see here. Right, see here now, like this tube is there, and this is what, let us suppose A arm, this point I am denoting as a P point, P opening, this is also Q opening. There are two openings, P and Q. You try to draw the uniform, this, what you can say, tube. Right, so there are two openings, P and Q. Okay, any doubt? Okay, so now there is another tube you see here which is having a movable arm. This is a tube which is having movable arm like this, which we can move like this. We can slide this tube. Okay, like this tube is there. This is now B tube. Let us suppose this is B tube, and we can move this tube this side and this side. So this is tube A, this arm is fixed, and this arm we can move. For example, suppose I have moved this like this. Something like this, that we will see later, next part, right? So see here, now we will take first of all one tuning fork here. Let me explain. This is a tuning fork which we have taken here at the point P of some frequency. What we did, we have taken one tuning fork of some frequency, and we have hammered on rubber pad and brought near to the end P, where we have brought near to the end P. Now what happens here? There are two waves which will transfer like this, in this direction and in this direction. Yes. Now this wave will come here. Yes. and it will come like this out from this. Here also it will come out from like this. And here, if suppose there is air, then you can hear the maximum or minimum intensity of sound. What is that? Maximum or minimum intensity of sound. Why? Because of what? Because of interference. You know, constructive interference, destructive interference. In constructive interference, you are having intensity maximum. In a destructive interference, you are having intensity minimum. Yes or not? Right? So let's see. Now, first of all, what I am doing here, you can see what we did. We have taken a tuning fork, right? And there is one opening, P opening. Here is another opening, that is Q. So here you can listen or you can feel the interference of sound from here. Two waves are going. So this tube is fixed and having two ends. This is movable tube. How it is movable? Let us suppose from this P end to the Q end, you are having length L1. Okay. P end to Q end, what is the length? L1. So see here, P to Q, length is how much? Length is L1. Agar hum P to Q length dekhe, to kitna length hai? L1. Next one. Which one? This for tube A. This for tube A. I am writing here tube A also. Otherwise, you will say from this side also P and Q only. No, this side for tube A. For tube A. Next one. Again, I am writing P to Q only. Length of this tube B is equal to how much? L2. This is what? L2. From where to here? This one. Before moving, okay? Before moving it is. So this part complete here like this. This one. This is what? L2. See here. I am denoting here in the diagram only. This is what? L2. Which is fixed. Fixed tube ka length kitna hai? L2. Now, we know, see here, if suppose now for maximum, for constructive interference, we know the phase difference. See here, for constructive interference, constructive interference, what is the path difference? Bolo, path difference kitna hai constructive ke liye? Constructive ke liye hame path difference aaya hai. Kal humne dekha hai, path difference is equal to n lambda. Agree everyone? What is path difference there? N lambda. Now, what is path difference here? Can I write like this? Therefore, L2 minus L1 is equal to n lambda. Call this equation number 1. What we got? L2 minus L1 is equal to n lambda. Call this equation number 1. Now, what we are doing now in the next case, see here. If or now tube B is pulled by distance x, we can say. Matlab kya kiya? Ye jo pull kiya hai wo kitna hai? Yes, tell me how much this is x. Whatever this movable arm is there, we have pulled here. Humne kya kiya hai? Isko khicha hai. Now, how much will be the length now? See here. Then your L2 dash will change. means L2 will change now to L2 dash. Now this is x and this one is also x. Here x, here x. How much change? Can I write like this? L2 plus 2x. What we did, listen. We have pulled this tube of length L2 by x amount. Here x and here. This part will remain same only. Just this part we have. Means this part will come little here now. X and this x. How much? 2x. That's why L2 dash will become L2 plus 2x. Is that clear? What it will become? L2 dash is equal to L2 plus 2x. First note down this all. Note down fast. Note down fast. Sir, can you explain again experiment? Yes, I will explain again. Listen, what we are doing, this is what Quinn's interference tube. Okay, what is this? Quinn's interference tube. In this, what is the use of this tube? This tube we are going to use for study of interference of sound waves, and we are also finding the speed of sound in air. What are the two applications of this tube? First one, we can study the interference of waves, right? And next one is sound speed in air. Obviously, these are the sound waves which we are transmitting here. Now, this tube is having one arm fixed. This arm is fixed. This tube is tube A. This is fixed. It is having two openings. One is P, another is Q. From P, we will give the frequency. Yes, some tuning fork we will hammer and we will keep here. Then waves will transmit in two different directions. One half wave will go here or half wave may go this side. Next, here is, you can keep detector, or human ear is a very good detector of sound. So that's why we are listening here, maximum intensity of sound, or you may listen minimum intensity of sound also. Maximum intensity of sound when constructive interference occurs. Minimum intensity of sound when destructive interference is occurring. This side tube is there. This tube is having length L2. It is having one movable. This is what? Movable tube. We can pull or push inside. We can pull outside or push inside. So that the length of this will decrease or increase. Why to increase length? To change the path difference. Why to change length? To change the path difference. Okay. So that if path difference will change, definitely phase difference will change and we will get interference. Understood? Clear? Now what we did? PQ. You see here, this is a PQ. This tube is having length how much? L1. Length is how much? L1. Now, this is another tube, that is tube B. Tube B is having original length L2. Yes? Tube B is having original length L2. for constructive interference now for this condition, original condition before pulling out. Original condition, what is the path difference for constructive interference? N lambda. Now, L2 minus L1, this L2, because this wave will travel how much distance? L2 distance it will travel. This wave will travel how much distance? L1 distance. So, the path difference of these two waves is how much? L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda. For which? Constructive interference. L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda for constructive interference. Now tube B is pulled by distance X. Now this tube I have pulled like this. You can see these dotted lines. How much distance I have pulled? X distance. This X and this X. This will remain same. This X plus this X. So length means now wave how it will travel like this through this dotted line. How much distance that wave has to travel? L2 plus 2x. How much distance it has to travel? L2 plus 2x. Now you understood this part. Till here everyone understood. Please note down. Ask me doubts if you have any. Please ask your doubts if you have anything. Please note down. Question is asked, sir, generally a sound wave can't bend and it undergoes multiple reflections, but here are we neglecting or reflection doesn't occur? See, Ray, there is one U-shaped pipe. Yes, U-shaped pipe. Aap bolte ho, yes, you are speaking. Sound will travel. Obviously, there reflection takes place. Yes or not? So, by reflecting sound, multiple reflections are taking place and sound will travel. Okay, understood. Yes, everyone finished? Shall I erase the board? Yes. Okay. So I am erasing here. Now see here. What we did? Now tube B we have moved. How much distance? X. And L2 dash become L2 plus 2X. So see here. For next maxima. For next maxima. For next maxima, for next maxima, path difference is how much? N plus 1 lambda. Path difference will be how much? Path difference is equal to N plus 1 lambda for next maxima. Therefore, this is what L2 dash minus L1 is equal to N plus 1 lambda. Okay. This is what L2 dash distance wave has to travel is what now? L2 dash this one complete here you can see. Yes. This is L2 dash. And this one is what fixed? Fixed is how much? L1. L2 dash minus L1 is what your path difference, which is equal to N plus 1 lambda. Now only we got L2 dash. How much that is? See here. L2 plus 2x at the place of L2 minus L1 is equal to N plus 1 lambda. Call this equation number 2. What we did? We have called this equation as equation number 2. Now, let's move ahead. Now equation 1, what we are having? Equation we are having like this. L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda. And equation 2 we are having. What is equation 2? L2 plus 2x minus L1 is equal to N plus 1 into lambda. Call this equation number 2. Yes, these two equations we are having. Now what I am doing? Adding these two equations, or let's subtracting these two equations. On subtracting these two equations, what we are getting? On subtracting equation 1 and 2. So let's subtract. So this is minus, so I am multiplying this. This is also minus. Minus, this will become plus. And here it is minus. So this L2 will get cancel. This L1 will get cancel. Minus 2x is left here is equal to N lambda minus N plus 1 into lambda. So this is minus 2x is equal to N lambda minus this N into lambda, N lambda minus this is lambda. N lambda also cancel. Then minus 2x is equal to minus lambda, minus minus will get cancelled. You are getting lambda is equal to 2x. Any doubt? Any doubt, please ask. Sir, please explain one more time. Okay. See, I think till first part you understood. Yes? First part is what? We know in first case this is L1, this is L2. So path difference is what? L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda in the first case. L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda. In second case, what I am doing? I am pulling this tube little here. What is distance? X. So L2 dash will become now what? L2 plus 2x. L2 dash will become L2 plus 2x. Therefore, here you see path difference is what now in this second case? This L2 dash minus this L1. L2 dash we know. L2 dash how much? L2 plus 2x minus L1 is equal to n plus 1 lambda. Why n plus 1 lambda? Because of next maxima. Because of next maxima. Therefore, you are getting this path difference now. L2 plus 2x minus L1 is equal to n plus 1 lambda. Now what to do? One equation is what? L2 minus L1 is equal to n lambda. Another equation is this. L2 plus 2x minus L1 is equal to n plus 1 lambda. Just subtract these. This sign will be minus. This will be minus. This will become plus. L1 plus L1 cancel. L2 minus L2 cancel. This minus 2x left here. This n lambda minus n plus 1 lambda. Then minus 2x. This n lambda. Minus n into lambda, minus n lambda, minus 1 into lambda, minus lambda, this will get cancelled. Then minus 2x is equal to minus lambda, and then lambda is equal to 2x. Understood? Yes? Yes, finish this part. Lambda is equal to 2x. Understood, everyone? Okay. Now, let me erase this diagram. Now we got lambda is equal to 2x. Now, if Tuning fork is having frequency f. If tuning fork is having frequency f, then we know phi is equal to what is formula? F into lambda. What is this? Then, if tuning fork is having frequency F, then P is equal to F lambda. So therefore, V is equal to F into 2x. Yes, where V is what? Speed of sound, we can say. What is here? Speed of sound. Yes, and F is what? Frequency of tuning fork. And x is the displacement of tube. So can you find out velocity? Yes. Or speed? Can you find speed of sound? Yes, we can find out speed of sound also. We can find out even frequency also. We can find out displacement of that tube also. Any one thing, two things we know, the third we can find out. Yes, note down. Yes, finished everyone. Yes, everyone finished. Shall I erase it? Any doubt? It is very simple. What we are doing, one time we are keeping the both arm length of the tube. Rendu tube nagada, length is the same. Length is same in first case. Path difference is what? L2 minus L1 is equal to N lambda. Ho gaya, right? Next, tarvata em cheddam, we are pulling little tube. How much distance? X. X below X, above X. How much? 2X. Length will change by yanta? L2 plus 2X. L2 dash is what? L2 plus 2X. Then next maxima. When we are pulling that tube, we are getting next maxima. So what is the path difference there? L2 dash minus L1 is equal to N plus 1 lambda. And substitute their L2 dash value. How much that is? L2 plus 2x. And just make two equations. Subtract them. You will get lambda value. Understood? Yes? Okay. Let's solve one small problem on this. Let's solve the small problem on this Quincke's interference tube. So see here. A tuning fork. Very simple problem. Do it yourself. A tuning fork of frequency 512 hertz is used. in Twinks tube apparatus. If velocity of sound is 340 meter per second, or you can write speed of sound. If speed of sound is 340 meter per second, then what will be the length of tube to pull outside? What will be the length of tube to pull outside? Yes, a tuning fork of frequency 512 hertz is used in Twinks tube apparatus. If speed of sound is 340 meter per second, then what will be the length of tube to pull outside? Very easy question, you can do yourself. Try it. So here frequency is given. Frequency is how much? 512 hertz. Next one, you can write F because we have denoted by F. So F. And speed is given how much? 340 meter per second. X we don't know. X we have to find. First you find X and then you can find out 2X also. Not an issue. Or else if you will find X also, enough. X also you can find. Not an issue. So here, what is the formula which we are going to use? V is equal to F lambda, that is equal to F into 2x, and we have to find x. So x is equal to V by 2f. Do it. V you know, F you know, do it yourself and send me the answer. In centimeter it should be. Answer should be in centimeter. Do it. How much answer you are getting? 33 centimeter. Square 41.2 centimeter. Check it once. 0.33 centimeter nahi re, meter hota hai wo, meter. That is meter. Check karo. Nihant ko 33 centimeter. I think Nihant ka answer right hai. Ek bar check karo. 33.2 ये कौन है? आदित्य. Those who got, check it once. I think 33 is the right answer. Check, check करो एक बार. Aryan, you check. ये विवेक है क्या? थर्टी मीटर कौन है रे? 30 मीटर कैसे? चेक करो. वेरी इजी प्रॉब्लम आई हैव गिवन. आई थिंक इट इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड जस्ट हाउ टू यूज. रामादित्य. ओके थर्टी फोर पॉइंट एट सेंटीमीटर. ओहो ओके लेट्स सी हाउ मच हेयर पी इज हाउ मच हेयर गिवन 340 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इनटू 512 यस 340 बाय 2 इनटू 512 तो करो शॉर्ट करो उसको इट इज वेरी इजी डू इट योरसेल्फ. You are getting answer 0.332 in meter. X is equal to how much? 0.332 meter. Is that clear? And if it is in meter, 1 meter is equal to how much? 100 centimeters. So many are committing mistake. Meter to centimeter also. So many are doing point this side only. Don't go like that. Meter is bigger, centimeter is smaller. Then just substitute there. X is equal to how much? 0.332 into 100 centimeter. So this is equal to 33.2 centimeter. We have to pull. Okay. If you will, when college will start, no, we will do this experiment. Okay. You come to me. Means at for next maxima, you have one more resonance tube we are doing, that is in our practical, but this is not in our practical. So we will do that with that elongation of tubes and all, that twins tube we will create, and we will do that experiment. Then you will understand very nicely how we can find out velocity of sound by using that twins tube. Even by using resonance tube also we can find out the speed of sound or velocity of sound. Yes. So do this like this and solve. It is very, very easy basic question so that you will understand how we are going to find the speed of sound or frequency or even X also by using Twing's tube. Okay, so note down this all. So we will stop here, revise the notes, ask me doubts. If it is out of the concept, please call me. If it is related with concept, you can ask. Any doubt, don't kill, but call me later also, you can call. Okay? So we will stop here. Have a good day.